On today's Maker Mashup, I'm gonna try to save your step sticks from certain doom in the SKR2. Okay, so in today's video, I'm hopefully going to save you from blowing up an entire set of step sticks in your new SKR2. And I suggest you share this video with as many people as possible. We really need to get the word out here, because if you buy this brand new board and you install a TMC2209 the exact way that they say in the current existing documentation, you're almost assured to blow up all of the step sticks that you've installed into the SKR2. Okay, with the PSA out of the way, let's talk about what happened here in the last 24 hours. So I woke up this morning and I got an email from BigTreeTech. Basically, I'm sorry to disturb you. Our company has seen that you've posted a video on YouTube. Please listen to me here. Please stop using the BigTreeTech SKR2 in your hand, because now our company has found SKR2 TMC2209 can't be used for the components of this product. Now it has been updated. I will reissue the updated BigTreeTech SKR2 for you later. Also, please provide your address. I will ship it for you as quickly as possible. Sorry for the inconvenience. All right, so I'm like, what is going on? So I emailed BigTreeTech back. I said, I just ordered 20 of these. We use them in our 3D printers here, and we're selling them on layerfuse.com. What is going on? So they replied basically back and said, reach out to my contact in sales and they'll worry about a refund on this. So I did reach out to my contact in sales, and he was actually far more helpful than the original email that I got. In talking with Mike, who's my contact there at BigTreeTech, he said, we found a problem with the board. It's related only to some boards and only the TMC2209s or other ones that are using those extra pins for the sensorless homing. So I said, well, can I get some steps to reproduce? How do I know that I have bad boards here? And he said, I can't really help you with that, but he gave me another contact, Mr. Sue at BigTreeTech, and I reached out to him via Skype, and we had a short conversation about what the issue was, because what I wanted to do was to identify whether or not my boards were affected, because Mike said he really wasn't clear on if this was every board or only some boards. I'd seen a lot of different people with comments in the last video and that saying that they had problems with the 2209s and they weren't working in the board. Matter of fact, one person said he received a whole set of bad step sticks. So I think that was really where this started, was that there was people that were having a problem. They were reporting it to support. So I asked Mr. Sue, hey, can you give me some steps to reproduce this issue so that way I can actually see where the problem is breaking down? He said, sure, give me a few minutes. Came back and he gave me this document here that I'm going to share with everybody here. And there's going to be a link down in the description so you can download it in the event that BigTreeTech hasn't posted it on their website just yet. So essentially, there was no steps to reproduce. What they did was they gave me what the fix was. And based on the fix and how this plays out, it really does sound like what happens is that if you do not attach these two grounds together on the board itself, what's going to happen is at some level, the step sticks are basically going to fry, and it affects all the step sticks on the board, not just the one TMC2209, but everything that's been installed. And that would go along with what we were seeing, which was a few people that said, hey, I had a whole set of bad step sticks. So the step sticks weren't bad, but the SKR2 actually fried the step sticks, which made them unusable. And then what was happening was, is on the screen of the display, you would see that there was a TMC connection error, or if you ran the 122M command, it would basically come back and say that there was no connection to the TMC drivers. So luckily, I had not installed the step sticks yet into this board. I'd been using the SD card that I had and I loaded it onto the main board, but I didn't install any of the step sticks. And that really was my saving grace in that I didn't blow up any step sticks or have any problems. And I followed the directions in this document that I'm sharing with you. So this is a workaround that you can do, but I really recommend that once BigTreeTech does get these boards fixed and out in the marketplace, that you go ahead and get a replacement board. My concern with this fix is just that if a wire comes loose, then you're gonna fry all your step sticks in the board itself. So with all that said, let's get to work. So the fix for this is really pretty simple. We're gonna connect a wire from the ground on the end stop switch to the ground in the closed loop stepper. Then inside the firmware, we need to disable the new functionality that is to prevent you from frying your step sticks if you insert them incorrectly. So basically if they're twisted around, so the top is at the bottom and the bottom to the top, what happens if you enter them reversed, it would fry your step stick. And in this particular case, yes, the irony is so thick that if you insert them the right way and have this functionality installed with the TMC2209, you'll fry all the step sticks in your main board. Okay, so here we have my SKR2 and I've already got the step sticks installed. Now you can see here I've got on these two ports, and this is normal for an X301. We've got in our X and Y ports, we have our TMC2209s. And then over here, I've got two TMC2208s. Usually I have some 2225s in there, but these are some older TMC2208s. So if I had a problem with this board, I would be frying an old step stick that I'm not actively using. I was really hoping I didn't fry any, and we didn't. So let's get into what this fix is. So what we're gonna basically do is, over here we've got the end stops, and the center pin of these X and Y end stops is the ground. Then what we're gonna do is we're just gonna add a jumper to the third pin of the closed loop steppers here. And what that does then is it joins these two grounds together. Now, alternatively, and I don't like this solution only because the wiring becomes a bit messy, is that you could take these same grounds that are the center pin grounds here, and then you can ground them here on your power. And that documentation does cover that. I think the two jumpers here are really pretty easy. Your TMC2209s come with these type of jumper wires anyhow, so it makes it really simple to just take one of those and use that instead of a SPI connection. You can go ahead and just use this to link the grounds. So I've got a couple wires that I was using earlier today, and what we're gonna do is we're just going to take the center pin. I'm gonna put one jumper there, and we'll do another one for the Y. And then we just wanna link them back. So the third pin in here on the closed loop stepper, we'll add that one. And then the same thing here on the third pin in, we add the ground here. So as you can see, what we've got is a ground from these closed loop stepper ports to the center pin on the end stops here. Now, once you've got this installed, your board to act like you would expect. You get the sensorless homing, the steppers move just fine, and your display and everything works. Now, I've got a little bit of a timing issue on this display that I didn't adjust in the firmware, so it's gonna look a little funky, but that's pretty normal for these inexpensive displays. It's just a fix in the firmware. So I'm gonna turn the board on now. And you can see we get the Marlin bug fix, and this is the same firmware that BigTreeTech has on their repo, and it says SKR2 ready. You can see there's no TMC connection error there. And we're gonna go down to motion, and we'll move the X. And you can see the stepper over here is moving just fine. And then we're gonna go up here and we'll try the same with the Y. And this stepper is moving just fine. And we're gonna try our Z. Now this is using the 2208s. And there we go. That one's moving fine as well. So as you can see here, once you put these jumper wires in place, the TMC2209s work just fine. And you also have your TMC2208s, or if you have 2225s in your X301 build, it'll work just fine. Okay, as you can see, the fix for this is really simple, but like I said, my concern with all of this is that if one of these wires do come loose, then you're gonna end up frying the entire board. But if you already have this board and you simply just wanna use it, you can go ahead and use these jumper wires the same way I did, and that will go ahead and fix your problem and prevent your step six from blowing up. So the choice is really yours, and I do wanna thank BigTreeTech for at least reaching out and letting me know immediately so I could put this video together and let all of you know. For those of you that have already had a problem with this, I'm really sorry to hear that. Please reach out to BigTreeTech. They've been really receptive about this issue and doing more or less like a recall on these boards and trying to replace them for end users. So I have to say that they're really trying to stand behind this issue and get it fixed. So please reach out to them if you're having a problem. But this fix, as you see, does work and does allow you to use the TMC2209s or any other driver that is using that sensorless homing. And if you're using another driver like a TMC2208, presumably we're not having an issue with that. I haven't heard any problems with those sorts of installations. It's only the sensorless homing. So at least it's very limited. So hopefully a lot of people don't blow up their step sticks using the new SKR2. So with that, it's gonna bring the end of today's video. If you liked it, make sure you mash that like button and please share this video as much as possible. I really wanna make sure that we get the word out just to save somebody some money and aggravation on the TMC2209. And don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss any update videos on the SKR2 like this one here. So with all that said, I wanna say thanks again for watching and we'll see y'all next time.